The Millenium Heights Medical Complex is experiencing a bed crisis. According to the MHMC, this is partly due to the nation's scourge of non-communicable and chronic diseases, along with crime and violence. Dr. Bernadette Joseph Labadie, head of the Accident and Emergency Department, says over the past several months, the A&E department has seen an increase in patients seeking urgent and emergency care at the OKEU. Monthly, she says they see 1,700 patients, with over half suffering from NCDs.
This situation is further compounded by the increase in motor vehicle accidents and injuries due to violence, such as gunshot wounds and stab wounds. As a result, some patients who require admission to the hospital are kept in the ER, where they are cared for until a bed becomes available on the wards. Over the past few months, on any given day, the ER has between 25 and 30 admitted patients waiting for beds on the wards.
She says that the ER currently comprises 23 beds. Therefore, she says the increase in patients presenting themselves to the ER hampers staff's ability to handle emergencies and provide a bed for every patient. These are some of the solutions that the OKEU's ER has implemented.
One of these solutions was the opening of a special 7-bed unit called a transition unit for stable patients whilst they await a bed on the ward. And this transition unit is adjacent to the emergency department. We have also made beds available at the secondary care hospital, previously known as the Victoria Hospital. Efforts have also been made to improve the overall experience when a patient arrives at the ER, resulting in a smoother flow. And this includes a new registration area and triage room.
The World Health Organization recommends a minimum of 2 beds per 1,000 population. Therefore, with the island's population, there should be 360 inpatient beds. However, Dr. Lisa Charles, Director of Clinical Services, says tertiary medical institutions combined present only 237 beds, two-thirds of what is needed.
The Millennium Heights Medical Complex is looking at increasing our bed capacity. We're looking in two areas. We're looking down at the National Mental Wellness Center, where we have some space that we could hopefully repurpose into additional inpatient beds. And we're working across the way at Secondary Hospital, formerly Victoria Hospital, to convert beds there to manage patients who do not need tertiary care services. Those, again, the patients that we spoke to are recovering from a stroke who may need just rehabilitation and some level of support.
Further, Dr. Charles says, often, patients who are ready for discharge are kept longer as family members are not able to pick them up promptly after discharge. In addition, she says that extended hours at community wellness centers must be looked at to relieve pressure off the ER for non-emergency cases. Other areas which the MHMC says they are working on improving is communication with patients and family members, along with the timeliness of results for diagnostic investigations. In the meantime, the MHMC is urging the public to resolve conflicts without the use of violence, eat a healthy and balanced meal, exercise, quit smoking, drink in moderation, take prescribed medications, drive safely, and plan for the future. For the DBS News World, Miriam Montout reporting.